Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be discussing how to set up a basic 9030 PLC system. So what I have here in front of you is a full rack of modules. I'm going to describe IC693 PWR330 high capacity power supply, IC693 CPU 374 plus processor, IC693 CMM 321 Ethernet interface card, IC693 ALG 220 input analog voltage, and we have two discrete cards. This is an IC693 MDL 940 relay output 24 volt and a IC693 MDL 645 24 volt DC input. And these are all attached to an IC693 CHS 397 5 slot rack. Okay, so in Proficy Machine Edition, I've selected by clicking File and New a 9030 platform file. So I went into File, selected New, and then went to GE Intelligent Platforms 9030 PLC. Okay, and then this is what I have here, 9030 config. Okay. Now, I'm going to show you how I was able to get all of these slots filled and how I configured them. First, I started by right-clicking on slot number one. This is IC693 CPU 374, my processor. Right-click, configure. And what I've configured here is the Ethernet. And I've configured the Ethernet by right-clicking next to where it says IP address, data entry tool, and I was able to install this information that I've highlighted here in black. And I've chosen an IP address that's far beyond anything that's on our network, so it doesn't get confused with anything that somebody else has already established on the network. So I recommend that you do that. These relate to ports 1 and ports 2 on the Ethernet portion of the CPU 374 plus. Okay, the next thing is right click on slot number 2, and I'm going to start to fill the rack in the software. Right click slot number 2, add module, and we have, of course, an IC693 CMM 321 Ethernet interface, and some configuration is required. So when this pops up, slot number 2, I'm going to go to the IP address, double click or right click on it, and we're going to install an address that doesn't conflict with our CPU, and of course a subnet mask. Okay, all right, that's all established. Right click on slot number 3, our analog input card, which is an IC693 ALG 220. Now, there's no configuration here because it's already pre-selected for voltage and voltage only, and it only has 4 channels, which you'll also see the parameters, underneath parameters, the length, the amount of channels is 4. And if you put your cursor over it, your arrow, it'll say non-editable value. All right, you don't have a choice, there's 4 channels. And more importantly, they start at the reference address of percent analog input AI 00001. So when I go to my analog input table, I'll know where to find the readings from this card. All right, next is slot number 4. We have our discrete output. So I'm going to select that. I'm going to go down to MDL 940 right here, IC693 MDL 940. 16 circuit output relay as we described. I'm going to select that. And then that's going to be, this is pre-wired so that my outputs are going to go to my inputs, and I'll be able to test both of these modules at the same time, and I'll also be able to see it in my output and input table in Proficy Machine Edition. All right. this all, under parameters, there's nothing to configure here, but under parameters, you do want to be aware that when you want to turn your 16 channels on, you must start at percent Q or percent output 00001 is your first channel, and so on. And the length is 16. This is a non-editable value that can't be changed. Slot number 5, right click, add module. And this is discrete input. And it's an MDL-645. IC693 MDL-645 also a 16 circuit, just like the MDL-940, and also 24 volts DC. So I'm going to select that. Now, in the software, the rack is full. We have all 5 slots filled, starting with the CPU, the Ethernet card, analog input, discrete output, discrete input. So this is a pretty basic rack. It's a full rack, and this is a probably a good place for you to start to understand how this gets put together. Now I'm going to go to my online offline button. It's a lightning bolt icon. I'm going to click on that, and this is going to connect me to the processor. Took a second try there. We have this toggle to online mode, which is the green handprint icon. I'm going to click on that to go online. Next thing I do typically at the top of your screen, you'll notice a something called target. And if you go down to online commands and go to clear, what I usually do here, because this processor was or may have been used for something other than what we're doing right now. In other words, this processor might be looking for different modules or no modules at all. And now we have this completely new system and we're starting over fresh. So what I like to do is select controller fault table and IO fault table and clear those faults. Because like I said before, the processor is looking for something else or nothing else to the right of it, and select OK. If you don't do this, most times you will get hung up with some sort of a fault and you're going to have to go in and clear those faults. And I'll show you that as well, where you can find that and work with it. Next thing is the download and run icon. Download and start active target, which is this icon that I have the cursor over right now, the arrow. I'm going to select that. Then we're going to download this information to the processor. The first thing it's going to ask us is, what exactly do we want to download? So, if you look at the screen, I have selected hardware configuration and motion and logic. I don't have anything else selected because I don't want to actually put anything into the permanent flash memory or force any values. So I don't have anything else selected. This is just a simple test to get some modules in there and how to get it configured and into run mode. So I'm going to select OK. Next thing that's going to come up is the processor was being used, like I said, for something else before. So it's going to tell us that this folder does not match the target name and controller. Do you wish to overwrite logic and target and name and controller? Yes, because this is something new. Again, your application may be slightly different than what I'm doing, but this is just a basic example. And we do want to enable the outputs so that we could start seeing some activity. Now, if you could see where my arrow is, we're in run mode. The only thing that you could do from here is to stop the processor. We're going to leave it in run mode, of course, because we're going to run a couple tests to see that what we configured is actually working properly. The first thing we'll test is we'll just go to the CPU 374 and make our way to the other modules. I have here a local Ethernet cable that's plugged in, and I'm going to put it on my port number 1, and I have highlighted here the address ending in 215. I'm going to pull up my command prompt, and I'm going to ping that address. This happens to be an address that I had in here before. I'm going to select enter. So I know I have activity on port number one. I'm going to check port number two. On the hardware side, also please note that I usually wait for this LAN LED to start blinking. That way I know that this is fully connected. Again, I have a response. And then usually just for to make sure that I don't have it confused with anything else, I'll ping it one more time with it unplugged just to make sure that nothing else that's on the system is responding and giving me a false reading. So something to keep in mind just to test your test procedures. All right, the next thing I'm going to do is plug into our CMM321. And we've established a slightly different address for that, ending in 217, if you saw my configuration. Once the LAN LED, once again, is blinking, I'm going to go ahead and ping that. And immediately I have a response. So we know that this configuration has worked. I'm going to ping it without the plug in it, and I'm not getting a response at all. So that's perfect. I know that those are working well. Okay, the next thing is the analog input card. What we want to do is we're going to give this a small amount of voltage, 3 volts. And again, if you look at the arrow, I'm going to be looking at address AI0001. And this is where you find it in Proficy Machine Edition under default tables. I'm going to expand that, and you have all your reference tables here: analog input, analog output, input, output, genius global, internal, register, system, temporary. These are all the different reference tables. So I'm going to double click on analog input. You'll see a new tab pops up, and it has the values here, the 4 values. So when I put my 3 volt battery, I'm able to see, and I'm going to just point my arrow. This is reference number one, and you can see it pops up as I have the arrow over it as reference number one. Reference number two is just beside it. I'm going to try and activate that. Then we have a value. Okay. Number 3 and number 4. So this is the table that I go to read analog input. Same works with analog output, except you would be putting a value in order to receive a value on the other side of the output card. Okay, on to the input and output test. What I'm going to do is open the input table, and I'm going to go check my IC693 MDL645 to see what address I'm going to be looking for a response, and that's 161. So let's go see where that is. Okay, 161 is right here, right where I have this blue zero. And that's where I'm going to see, that'll be the first of the 16 channels that are going to change from a 0 to a 1 once I activate the output. Now I'm going to go to the output table by double-clicking on it down below. Starting at reference address 1, as we looked at before, And where these zeros are, as you can see, I have the box highlighted or closed out. I'm going to put a 1 in there and click enter. Move to the left, 1, enter. Left, 1, enter again. And I'm going to go through and do that until all my channels are on. Okay. So I've changed all my zeros to ones, and I've been able to turn on all of my outputs. I can see that here. But I also know that they're working because I'm getting a solid reading on the other side of the input, 1 through 8, both channels A and B. Now, where I want to look to make sure that that information is being sent over to Proficy Machine Edition, which would complete the test, is in my input table. So I select that tab. You can see that's highlighted now. And if you look down below where I have the input number 161, once this is up, selected, at the tip of my arrow, and then to the left, you'll see all 16 channels are on, two groups of 8 channels A and B. So that would conclude setting up a rack and then testing the rack to make sure that the information that I've configured and the modules that I've put in are able to read back to Proficy Machine Edition. So that pretty much concludes everything that I have set out to test and to configure. I hope this video has been helpful. Please keep us in mind for 9030, 9070, Genius IO, Field Control, Versamax, and Horner. We offer same-day shipping. And if that interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.